One of the most common reasons for engine failure in modified cars is due to oil starvation. When we have oil starvation, this results in a lack of lubricating oil reaching the engine bearings. And when this happens, the engine bearings can contact the crankshaft journal. This can quickly result in failure of the components. The most common lubrication system in a factory engine is what's referred to as a wet sump system. This involves an actual sump which contains the oil which is bolted to the underside of the engine block. A pickup located inside the sump draws oil into the oil pump, and here the oil is then distributed around the engine. The wet sump lubrication system may work fine for a factory car, which is unlikely to produce much in the way of cornering force, accelerating force or braking force, but once we start modifying that car, fitting stickier tyres and improved suspension, things can change. With a modified car, it's not uncommon to be able to pull in excess of 1 to 1.2 G in cornering. And when this happens under sustained cornering, the oil in the sump will tend to flow away from the pickup. If this happens, the pickup will pull in air rather than oil, and this is where that oil starvation issue occurs. While there are a variety of ways of addressing these problems, one of the most reliable and robust is to do away with the factory oiling system and go to what is referred to as a dry sump lubrication system. The dry sump system stores the engine oil in a remote reservoir. That reservoir can hold more oil than the factory sump normally holds, and the design or shape of the reservoir also means that regardless of the cornering, accelerating or braking forces being experienced, there's always a constant supply of oil at the base of the reservoir where it's picked up by the oil pump. In terms of the oil pump, this is another area that the dry sump system differs. Instead of a built-in oil pump contained inside the engine, a dry sump system uses an external oil pump which is driven by a pulley on the front of the crankshaft. The pump is actually a multi-stage unit which consists of a pressure stage which draws the oil from the remote reservoir and then pumps it through the engine, as well as several scavenge stages. Now, these scavenge stages are used to draw the oil as well as blow-by gases out of the crankcase and then return them into the remote reservoir. The advantages of a dry sump system when correctly set up include reliability, which we've already discussed, but on top of that, there can also be a small but measurable power improvement. This is because the scavenge stages will extract the blow-by gases from the crankcase, and this can help reduce windage losses, which occur when the crankshaft journals contact the oil vapor as it tries to spin inside the crankshaft. While fitting a dry sump system is a costly exercise, if you want ultimate peace of mind and reliability in a circuit or hill climb application, it is the ultimate. It's also only going to take a couple of damaged engines to quickly make that dry sump system seem really cost effective.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.